Now that's a man cave. Prince William watches England's World Cup victory and crowned Prince of Jordan's bolthole with a drink, baseball glove-shaped chair and a massive television screen. Hat-trick hero Harry Kane helped England secure their biggest ever World Cup victory as the Three Lions thrashed Panama 6-1 this afternoon. The historic performance in Nizhny Novgorod, which means England are through to the last 16 of the World Cup, was watched by 25 million jubilant fans in pubs, bars and living rooms across the country. For England fans around the world, it would have been impossible to avoid news of the score, except for one man. Prince William managed to escape the results all day before watching a recorded version of the match hours after it had finished. The Duke of Cambridge settled down with the Crown Prince of Jordan to watch England's match against Panama tonight, after begging photographers not to tell him what the score was. The pair enjoyed some refreshments while watching the World Cup game on an enormous television in a luxurious man cave in Amman, Jordan. The 36-year-old Duke of Cambridge, who is the president of England's Football Association, began a historic five-day tour of the West Bank today. He arrived in Jordan for the start of a trip that will see him become the first member of Britain's royal family to pay an official visit to both Israel and the Palestinian territories. The Duke touched down in Amman for a first leg build as a chance to bond with Jordan's Crown Prince Hussein bin Abdullah, 23, a fellow graduate of Britain's Royal Sandhurst Military Academy. During a lengthy conversation about football, the Duke laughed as he pleaded with journalists traveling with him on the plane, on pain of death, "Please don't tell me the score." He later revealed that his host, the Crown Prince of Jordan, had told his staff to record the match so they could watch it over dinner later that evening. Sure enough, the new friends nestled down on a sofa with some drinks to scrutinize England's performance in their second match of the tournament. And after Kensington Palace released a photo on Twitter of the Duke and Prince watching a rerun of the match in a stunning living room, social media users were quick to show their appreciation. William spoke at a reception at the British Embassy in Amman later on Sunday, praising the historic ties and friendship between Britain and Jordan. He also revealed that his wife, Duchess of Cambridge, spent almost 3 years in Jordan as a child when her father worked there for British Airways. Kate's family moved to Jordan in May 1984 when she was aged 2 and her sister Pippa was just 8 months old. She went to an English language nursery while her parents were in the country for almost 3 years, before they returned to Berkshire in 1986. The Duke said she was very sorry that she was not able to join him on the trip so soon after the April birth of their son Louis, later gushing about how much she loved living in Jordan as a child. But her family remembers very fondly the almost 3 years she spent here as a child, he said, adding that her positive experience is not unique. "The interchange between our two countries is real and it's deep," he said. "Work, study, tourism and family links. Our historic ties and friendship are played out in the lives of thousands of people who consider both countries home." Crown Prince Hussein bin Abdullah was stepping in for his father King Abdullah of Jordan, who is currently on a working visit to Washington, D.C., accompanied by Queen Rania, when Prince William disembarked his official British government plane shortly after 4 p.m. local time. William met Rania Malki, chief executive of Save the Children in Jordan, during the evening reception at the British Embassy. The charity boss said she knew the house where the Duchess lived while she was in Jordan because it is now the home of her children's pediatrician. "No way," the Duke replied. "She will be thrilled. She loved it here, she really did. She is very upset that I am coming here without her." Blue skies and blazing sunshine greeted the prince for the start of the trip that he is said to be very much looking forward to. William, who wore a navy suit, white shirt and sky blue spotted tie, will be traveling around in Jordan, Israel and the occupied Palestinian territories on behalf of the British government. Dozens of soldiers stood to attention in front of the British and Jordanian national flags, signifying the hugely important visit which Kensington Palace has said will build relationships which will last for decades to come. William looked relaxed and smiled broadly as he walked alongside the Crown Prince down a red carpet which had been rolled out to welcome him as he stepped onto the tarmac of the Queen Alia International Airport in the Jordanian capital. This afternoon, William began his trip by learning about the Crown Prince Foundation, an initiative of the heir to the Jordanian throne, with a tour of Fab Lab, designed to enable young people to explore advanced technology. On a tour of a technology lab, the avid Aston Villa fan was asked to start up a laser cutter which swiftly produced his favorite club's crest on a wooden shield as a surprise for him. "That's familiar," he said with a smile when he spotted the Villa crest on the machine. "Very good. You have done your research." William, 36, added, "That's very impressive." "Thank you very much." It was one of two Villa-themed gifts the second in line to the throne took away with him from the technology lab. He was also given a model of the gas tank on one of his beloved Ducati motorbikes bearing the Villa crest. He was driven to the Fab Lab, on a business park in the Jordanian capital Amman, by the country's heir to the throne, Crown Prince Hussein, who wanted to showcase the work his foundation is doing to equip young people with technology skills. The lab is one of its initiatives. Hussein, 23, a Sandhurst-trained second lieutenant in the Jordanian army, shares a passion for motorbikes with William. An Instagram picture of him with his machine and his boyish good looks have made him something of an international heartthrob. William was shown 3D printers, a drone, a robotic arm and other pieces of technology young people have created at the lab. Crown Prince Hussein introduced him to some of the students, including Hashim Tamnit, 19, who explained the intricacies of a small drone to him. "This is the first year he has been learning English," the Crown Prince said of the student. "Really?" William replied. "He is clearly very clever because he's leaning very fast." His own children are still infants, but when the Duke was shown a robotic arm drawing beautiful patterns, he told students, "This will be good for my children to start learning a bit of coding. It has to be helpful." Later tonight he will attend a Queen's birthday party at the residence of Britain's ambassador to Jordan, Edward O. Acton. The Duchess of Cambridge has not accompanied her husband on the trip as she is on maternity leave following the birth of their third child, Prince Louis. A Kensington Palace spokesman said, "The historic nature of this tour is of course important and the Duke considers it a great privilege to be undertaking the first ever official royal tour of Israel and the occupied Palestinian territories and to be able to help further strengthen the friendship between Jordan and the United Kingdom." William was taken straight from the airport to his first engagement, a tour of Fab Lab, designed to enable young people to explore advanced technology. During his two-day visit to Jordan, Prince William will visit the archaeological site of Drash as well as some education-related projects and the British Army base near the capital. The second in line to the British throne will then head to Israel Monday evening to begin his history-making visit to the Jewish state and occupied West Bank. He will hold talks with both Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas. Kensington Palace has underlined the non-political nature of His Royal Highness's role, in common with all royal visits overseas, but the region is a minefield of sensitivities. The visit comes at a particularly volatile time after U.S. President Donald Trump recognized Jerusalem as capital of Israel and moved Washington's embassy there, sparking Arab outrage and deadly clashes. Britain governed the region under a League of Nations mandate for almost three decades until Israel's independence 70 years ago, and is still blamed by both sides for sowing the seeds of a conflict that continues to rack the region. Ahead of William's arrival, the official schedule's reference to East Jerusalem as in the occupied Palestinian territory sparked particular anger among some right-wing Israeli politicians. Official visits by British royals take place at the request of the UK government, but statements from the prince's household have given little explanation for the timing of this trip. Israel has long pushed for an official visit by a member of the British monarchy. Other members of William's family, including his father Prince Charles, have made unofficial visits to Israel and East Jerusalem in the past. During the trip, William will have plenty of reminders of the British role in the region. In Jerusalem, he will stay at the King David Hotel, which was Britain's administrative headquarters during its rule of Palestine prior to Israeli statehood in 1948. In 1946, militant Jews waging violent resistance against British rule bombed the building, killing and wounding scores of people, many of them British civil servants or military personnel. A packed schedule will also see William meet with young people, British servicemen and Syrian refugees while in Jordan. In Israel, he will lay a wreath at the Yad Vashem Holocaust Memorial. He will visit the Mount of Olives in Jerusalem and pay tribute at the tomb of his great-grandmother Princess Alice of Greece, who was honored by Israel for sheltering Jews during World War II. In the occupied West Bank city of Ramallah, he is also set to meet Palestinian refugees and youths.